Ahmed did that, have them all debated. You're there on the, at the speaker's corners, Christians and Muslims debating. So how about we talk about us? Now I want you to ponder about this. We'll be talking to Christians, trying to prove to them. They know, they're all doubting. If Allah said they're doubting, they are doubting. They are doubting Trinity. You can't make them take that step. They will be taking it when it's time to take it. We'll be quoting them verses inside the Bible, like Matthew 19, 16, 17. When Jesus did not even want people to be calling him good master, he said, "Why are you calling me good? Only God is good." Jesus said, "Only God is good," to prove what? That he is not God. We be quoting them Mark 13, 32, saying what? Only the Father knows the hour. So Jesus is not the Father. So Jesus is not God. Because Jesus did not know the hour. We be saying that. We be saying them that Jesus in Hebrew 4:15, that Jesus was tempted. How can be God tempted for 40 days? So Christians know. They know God cannot be tempted by Satan. If Satan can tempt God, how can we be having a God? Jesus be sleeping. So if God sleeps, who gonna watch for the world? In John 5:30, Jesus is saying, "I cannot do anything on my own." So it gotta be somebody else doing it for Jesus. In John 11:35, Jesus is saying, Jesus be crying. You imagine God crying? Yes, we said that all those things. Jesus thirsty, John 4:6. So it's a, we can say Jesus asleep, Matthew 4:8-24. Luke 8:23, sleep. Jesus learning by experience. You imagine God not knowing the seasons, asking for mangoes, it's not mango seasons. Asking for coconuts, it's not coconut season. Asking for apples, he didn't know. He didn't know what a fire is. He had to put his hand on the fire to know. Imagine the God not knowing that. Yes, we said it all to Christians. We said it all. We taught them everything they need to know about what they need to know. People exaggerating. They're holding into, in the word, in the beginning was the word become flesh, and if they're holding onto that. No one goes to the Father but through me. They hold into that to say that he is God, right? You're telling them, no, you can't hold into that. Jesus is telling you that to go to God, you have to go through him, you have to follow his teachings, right? So, and many more. Many more verses that we could have quoted over here to show to people that Jesus is not God. Numbers 23:19. God is not a man of a son. God is no man, is no son. John 4:80. No one can see God. Did you see Jesus? Yes. So are you saying that you can see God? Jesus is telling you no one can see God. John 13:16, Jesus saying he's a slave of God. John 14:28, Jesus saying the Father is greater than I. John 8:28, Jesus is saying he got taught by God. So what else? How about we think about us? Now, are we going to base We're saying, because of this verse, of surah, because of two verses mainly, Wati'u Allah, Wati'u Rasul, follow Allah and His Messenger. And then that verse in Surah An-Najm saying, Wama yantiqu anil hawa inhu illa wahyun yuha. Anything he said is from Allah as a wahi. Are we going to base, like just like we reproaching to the Christians, are we going to base our knowledge on that to say anything that Muhammad said is from Allah? Seriously? What are those verses about? People saying to our prophet, oh, this is garbage. Your Quran is nothing. You be dreaming, you woke up, and then you write whatever you want to write. It's just magic. There ain't nothing. Allah brought that verse. No. Anything he just said is coming from me. It's a wahi. It's not dreams. It's not magic. No, it's none of that. They said, in haza illa qawlul bashar, right? In haza illa shahrun yusr. Allah is telling them, no, it's from me. What is it about? The Quran. The message. Why are we focusing on the messenger? How about the message? Now, how can you... Now, you say that, right? Just like the Christians basing their theories on God saying... and Jesus saying, no one goes to God but through me. And me and the God are one. They're saying that Jesus is God, right? So you basing yours on them two verses. Follow Allah and the Messenger. And this one that we took, anything he just said is from me, to say that anything Muhammad said is a wahi, is from Allah. Now think about it. If a Christian asks you, okay, your God is saying anything that Muhammad said is from him, right? It's a wahi, right? He said, right. So, is your God a hypocrite? He said, why? He said, because your God say, Ya ayyuha nabi lima tuharrimu ma ahala Allahu lak. Oh, you prophet, how can you be prohibiting what I have allowed? What I have made lawful? What is your answer to that? If Allah said, anything he says is from me. So when he prohibited, Allah should have said, yes, it's from me. Allah didn't say that. Allah said, no, you can't say that. Right? How many mistakes Muhammad made throughout the Quran? Allah fixing it. Allah correcting it. Allah said what? وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ مِنْ رَسُولٍ وَلَا نَبِيٍّ حَتَّى إِذَا تَمَنَّا خَلَقَ الشَّيْطَانُ فِي أُمْنِيَتِهِ. Never ever have I sent a messenger or a prophet without Satan trying to come and mess up his message. What I do, I protect him, I help him go deliver the message. So yes, Muhammad been tempted. So yes, he be making mistakes, not on the delivering the message, but in his real lifetime. So he made a ton of mistakes. He made a lot of mistakes throughout time, all in the Quran. Surah 33, Ahzab, how many mistakes? Abbasawatu Allah, the strongest oath in the Quran, Allah did it. Allah swore by cosmic things. But this time he swore that's the strongest. Fala uqsimu bima tubsirun wa ma la tubsirun. I, Allah, swear by anything you can see and anything you cannot see. What's left? Nothing. There's nothing in existence but something that you can see and something that you cannot see. That's the strongest oath of Allah. He said, if you, Muhammad, walaw taqawwala alayna ba'd al-aqawil, if you would have said anything outside the Quran, outside of what I said, la ahazna minhu bil yamin, we would have seized you for a right hand, summa laqatana minul wajhin, we were going to cut out your artery, fama minkum min ahadin anu hadizin, and none of you people would have been able to do anything. So Allah is telling us, not anything Muhammad said is not from him. Please think about it. How can you be going that far? How can you be saying that anything Muhammad said is from Allah? No, anything the message is from Allah. Can't you understand that? The same way you try to make Christian understand that me and the Father are one, and no one can go to the Father but through me. You can understand that through here? That anything he just said is from me? Doesn't mean that anything he would be saying is from me? Allah just said there is a possibility of him saying something that he did not say. If you would have said something that I did not say, I would have killed you. I would have cut you. And alas, and he did. He acted by ignoring this blind man. Allah corrected him. Between him and Zainab, you know, and Zayd, Allah corrected him. Between him and Al-Munafiq, Allah corrected him. So, him trying to prohibit what Allah has allowed, Allah corrected him. So what are you saying? Allah correcting himself? That Allah is lying? That Allah is a... What are you saying? Just let's look at a couple of hadiths. We saying anything that Bukhari and Muslim say is from Allah, right? It's from Muhammad, right? Anything sahih is good, right? Right? Okay. Muslim said the first surah, the first chapter revealed is Iqra in one hadith. In another hadith, he said it's Al-Mudathir. Which one is it? Is that Iqra or Al-Mudathir? Is that chapter 96 or chapter 74? We all know it's chapter 96. Why are we saying that the hadith saying is Al-Mudathir? Why is it Sahih? Another one. Did Prophet Muhammad see Allah? Bukhari say in 149, Bukhari say no, he didn't see him. That the Prophet didn't see Allah when he went up. Aisha said that. Muslim said 1334, yes, he did. Ibn Abbas said that. And you're saying they're both sahih? Are you serious? How about this hadith saying that the parents of Muhammad are in hell in Muslim? What did Allah say about that? Allah said, the only way you can go to hell, that's when you receive the message like those Christian people and you deny it. And you mock it, and you reject it, and you make fun of it. But if you did not receive a message, Ahlul Fatr, you do not go to hell. You're going to heaven. What did Allah say about Muhammad's parents? لِتُنْزِرَ قَوْمًا مَا أُنْزِرَ آبَاؤُهُمْ وَهُمْ غَافِلُونَ. To warn those whose parents was not warned. So the parents of our Prophet were not warned. So they're not going to hell. Allah saying they're going to heaven. So you believe this hadith is sahih? That our Prophet said that? No, he didn't. Another hadith. Muslims saying, to protect yourself from Dajjal, you gotta recite the 10 first verse of Surah Al-Kahf, Surah 18. Muslim 4:17:66. Another one saying, no, it's the last 10 verses. Which one is it? 10:4:17:67. Two hadiths next to each other in Muslim. One says it's the first 10, one says it's the last 10. And they both sahih? No way. How about that last sermon that our Prophet did? Did he say I left the book? Or I left the book with my sunnah? Or I left the book with Ahlul Bayt? Bukhari said, I left the book. Muslim said, I left the book with Ahlul Bayt. Mustadrak and is it, you know, and another one, and Imam Malik, which one is it? Said that I left the book with my sunnah. Which one is sahih? If Bukhari and Muslim are both sahih, so why aren't he saying the book or the book and Ahlul Bayt? Where he got the sunnah from? Dajjal, is he blind of one eye, right eye, left eye? Muslim saying 41710, Abu Hudayf saying it's left eye. Muslim saying 41705, Ibn Umar saying no, it's right eye. And they both sahih. So Dajjal is blind in one eye, is in one hadith is right and one hadith is left, and they both good. You serious? I can go on and on and on. I just want the video to be short, please, brothers and sisters. Think about all those hadiths. We should be following one rule. Why aren't we all fasting the same day? Why are we fasting different days in different countries? We got an ummah. We see the sun. We all should start fasting. I mean, we see the moon, the crescent. And then we see it again, we all stop. We see it in China, we all stop. Then we see it in Senegal, we all stop. We see it in Saudi Arabia, we all stop. We see it in France, we all stop. What's the problem? How can we go into Mecca doing the pilgrimage together if we don't fast the same days? If those start Ramadan before other one? Let's ponder on those hadiths, brothers and sisters. We cannot be here trying to convince Christians that Jesus is not God. Yes, Jesus is not God. Absolutely not. He is not God. We use the same hadiths. You cannot use those two verses in the Quran saying that anything Muhammad said is coming from Allah. No, he made mistakes. A hadith from Omar Ibn Khattab on the strategy of war. When he came and said something about how they're going to plan the war, Omar said, are you sure? Is that a wahi or is just your idea? He said, no, it's just my idea. He said, no, it's a bad idea. He followed Omar and they won. So not everything he say is from Allah. No, absolutely. Allah never said that. Everything he said, he just said right now that people was criticizing, was mocking about. Allah said, that was from me. It was a wahi. Please, sisters and brothers, peace be upon all of you. Please think about it. Please, don't be diverting. Allah said, وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ اشْمَأَزَّتْ قُلُوبُ الَّذِينَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْآخِرَةِ وَإِذَا ذُكِرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ دُونِهِ إِذَا هُمْ يَسْتَبْشِرُونَ. If you talk about Allah only, people get mad. If you put another name next to Allah, if you put hadith next to Allah, people are happy. Allah said, وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ رَبَّكَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَحْدَهُ. If we talk about Allah using the Quran only, they get mad. وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِهِمْ نُفُورًا. وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ رَبَّكَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَحْدَهُ. It be wrongly translated. That وَحْدَهُ is for the Quran. Quran وَحْدَهُ. Not Allah وَحْدَهُ. Not رَبَّكَ وَحْدَهُ. You know the rules of the grammar. It's not وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ رَبَّكَ وَحْدَهُ فِي الْقُرْآنِ. No. وَإِذَا ذَكَرْتَ رَبَّكَ فِي الْقُرْآنِ وَحْدَهُ وَلَوْ عَلَىٰ أَدْبَارِهِمْ نُفُورًا. If you preach Allah using only the Quran, they get mad. Why? Peace be upon all of you. Please think about it. We should be all one. Please think about those hadiths. Those are bad hadiths dividing us. Please, sisters and brothers, this is your brother's ultimate truth. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.